If you're looking for some of the best old-fashioned burgers in town, Lotta Burger is the place to go for all of your favorites. Lotta Burger, 2260 South 3rd, Memphis, Tennessee, 901-946-2001. They're open Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6:45 p.m. And the items on their menu include single, double, triple burgers, Philly sandwiches, smoked sausage, beef hot dogs, grilled cheese, tenders, fries, onion rings, and more. Call in orders must be done before 11 a.m. No calls accepted after 11 a.m. Drive-thru is available. Hungry for a burger? Lotta Burger, 2260 South 3rd, Memphis, Tennessee, 901-946-2001. Don't just settle for any burger. Get a Lotta Burger.
Are you tired of going to the doctor with the same issue over and over again and never getting any relief? Are you tired of buying all types of vitamins and supplements, hoping but not knowing for sure that they will keep you healthy? Or are you getting enough of the right kind of nutrients that your specific body needs? If you answer yes to any of these questions, you need a nutritional blood analysis. With a nutritional blood analysis, we can take one drop of blood from a prick of your finger and analyze your body's nutritional needs, nutritional deficiencies, and nutritional imbalances. This analysis can provide an early warning of possible future health challenges, so you can make the changes now to avoid the negative outcome. A nutritional blood analysis can be used to monitor a health challenge before and after adopting an approach to restore health and balance. It will also allow you the ability to determine the effectiveness of various approaches to restoring and balancing your health. So don't wait. Make your appointment. Stop guessing with your health. Know what works for sure. 901-602-7063.
Graphic Printing, located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, a complete print shop for all your printing needs. They do it all. Color copy, resume, funeral program, rubber stamp, full-color business cards, wedding and graduation invitations, and more. 30-plus years of quality work and service. They're open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m., located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-345-9294.
C-Graphics Printing. CJU's Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJU's Appliances have the best prices in town. Sales and service, heating and air. Also the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever you need. And used appliances, and folks up there, they're the best used appliances anywhere you find. That's CJ Used Appliances, 3530 Jackson Avenue. All appliances come with warranty. You can call them at 901-487-7882. Again, 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances.
CNS Motors Auto Sales, located at 2508 Southern Avenue, here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-323-8778. CNS Motors Auto Sales has been around since 1984. Go by and see Chris today for some of the best pre-owned and used vehicles in the city. They have SUVs, minivans, cars, trucks, whatever you're looking for in pre-owned used vehicles. Hey, you can find it right there at CNS Motors Auto Sales. See Chris since 1984. They will treat you right. Call them at 901-323-8778. That's 901-323-8778. 2508 Summer Avenue, CNS Motors Auto Sales.
This is Sergeant Chris Richardson with the Tennessee Highway Patrol. We're here to explain the Tennessee Hands-Free Law, which is a new state law effective July 1st, 2019. In Public Chapter 412, it makes it illegal for a driver to hold a cell phone or a mobile device with any part of their body to write, send, or read any text-based communication, to reach for a cell phone or a mobile device in a manner that requires the driver to no longer be in a seated driving position or properly restrained by a seatbelt, to watch a video or a movie on a cell phone or a mobile device, and to record or broadcast video on a cell phone or a mobile device. So, can I still talk to my cell phone while driving? Yes. A driver is permitted to use an earpiece, headphone device, or device worn on a wrist to conduct a voice-based communication. Driver may use one button on a cell phone or a mobile device to initiate or terminate voice communication, and voice-based communication may also be used to send a text message. Learn more at handsfreetn.com.
further ado, real quick, matter of fact, the rest of the social media, let me throw that in there as well. Twitter at TalkBackLive, that's one word, at TalkBackLive. Also Facebook, facebook.com, TalkBackLive with Josh. Like our Facebook page, check us out there, as well as TalkBackLive Network on Facebook.
Turn me down. Just a little. Okay.
Okay, good deal.
All right, you need to probably turn it back up a little bit, but that's good right there. Okay, boy, you were banging in my ears, I tell you what, but go ahead.
Yes, sir. And WTBL TalkBackLive Network as well. So, y'all got stuff, and you will be in the know and connected to what we're doing. So, that should do it.
All right, and Josh, let's get it all kicked off on a Thursday.
All right.
Welcome to all you checking in, coming in, and good topics today. And in the headlines today, we've got there are several fast food restaurants everywhere you go. They're all over the place. And, you know, sometimes people are satisfied, sometimes people are not. Well, what do you do when you're satisfied? Well, what do you do when you're not satisfied? And what kind of customer service do you get? And are you welcomed with something that becomes a big, big surprise? Well, let's talk about it. Josh, we have a story beginning this morning. McDonald's customer down for the knockout.
Yes.
What round was it?
Looked like the first round.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, man. Insane stuff going on. So, y'all check this out, man. McDonald's, I'm sure most people have, right? At some point in their life.
Yeah, who hasn't?
If you've been in your life, you've most likely had terrible service. At some point in your life.
At some point.
Yeah, I'm talking about cold.
And you probably had good service, too.
Yeah, but I'm talking about cold. Yeah. Right here, I'm talking about cold.
Fries at McDonald's is terrible.
Yes, it'll punch somebody. Because
now, when they're hot, they're okay.
They're awesome. They're awesome.
We don't eat them that much. But when they're hot, they're good. If they're cold and messy, they're full of grease.
Yeah.
I can't even say grease.
It's just cold.
It's just cold.
It just tastes like frozen sticks of nothingness.
I guess that's anything. I guess.
Well, true. But look, the fries are usually can be cold a lot of times. The Big Mac is without the Mac. You know what I'm saying? There's no special sauce, with the all beef patties.
Two all beef patties, special sauce, leaded cheese, pickled onions on the sesame seed bun.
But it ain't the same without the special sauce.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes they'll forget the patty. So, man, depending on where you go, you can get some real messed up service. And this lady, in this story we're about to show you, was sick of it. And evidently, McDonald's got sick of her. And she ended up on the floor.
Well, both of them got sick of each other, and it didn't turn out too good.
Shout out to Kelly said McDonald's on 3rd and Brooks.
Oh,
so he's calling them out in particular.
Wait a minute, what's wrong with you're gonna have to fill us in now? 3rd and Brooks. Where is 3rd? Is that downtown?
I think so. Let's know, Kelly, for sure.
Yeah, where is 3rd and Brooks?
And funny thing about it, I think, you know, we're looking at the explanation points.
Yeah.
It looks like Kelly's speaking from the heart with that one. So, but man, y'all check this out. So, we ended up with some injuries because of the McDonald's retaliation.
That was a big punch.
Yes.
And put her on the floor.
Yeah, knocked out the customer. So,
yes, indeed.
You want to find out how in the world that happened? Well, we're going to get this story up for you in just a second, man. But It's insane. And y'all let me know, or was it legitimate?
Yeah.
Was there anything legitimate?
Once they see this, know, was it legitimate or not? I mean, this person, well, this customer, yeah, really is one of those customers, I don't know, that fast food restaurants, they really don't like. I mean, he said everything. He said everything. That's not good, Kelly. That's not good. But
here it is.
Yeah.
But we got the story.
Okay. So, yeah, we have the story ready to go. And take a listen to this and just determine on your own what kind of punch did she get. Take a listen. Take a watch and a listen.
I wanted to get some Happy Meals and some cheeseburgers. And that was a very unhappy day for me.
Brittany Price's injuries remind her of this day anytime she looks in the mirror. It was September 22nd. A quick stop through the drive-thru at the McDonald's on Coleraine Avenue near Ronald Reagan Highway ended inside with food she says wasn't right, flying at a manager and a blender hitting her in the face, shattering her cheekbone and breaking her nose.
I've had surgery. I've had a lot of doctor's appointments, the follow-up, hard mornings, hard afternoons.
The video shows Brittany come inside the restaurant with what she says was a messed up order. She's waiting and waiting for it to be fixed with four children in the car. She even refills their drinks to kill time. As she waits, other customers come and go.
Yes, I mean, I wasn't the only one that got frustrated. You know, watching the video, we see a lot of people that see me and her talking, trying to resolve the issue, and they're like, I'm not dealing with this. You know, they just left. They didn't even place their order.
The time code shows after waiting about 23 minutes, Brittany goes to the car to grab the rest of her order to ask for a refund.
Then it's like you're directly ignoring me. So what choice do I have? I don't have to put up with this. So I went and got the food. I want my money back. And that's kind of where it all goes from there.
The video shows about 25 minutes after she first entered the store, Brittany throws multiple bags of food at the manager. The manager apparently throws a blender at Brittany, and it ricochets off her face.
Hey, well, maybe you shouldn't have thrown the food. When you look back at it, is it one of those things where it's like hindsight 2020? How does that...
I mean, I definitely don't feel like there would have been a different result. I feel like even if we would have just went verbal back and forth, that it still would have escalated to something else.
All right, so Brittany's attorney says they are pursuing a civil lawsuit. Again, no criminal charges have been filed in this case. We tried to reach the manager for her side of the story, but have been unable to do so. Sheree.
All right, there you have it. And my, did she hit the floor. But what do you think, folks? She is pressing a lawsuit? Do you think she'll win? Well, she because she didn't win that
she
fight.
She didn't win the fight, no.
No, she didn't. But what do you think, folks? This lady came and she ordered her food. She was hot. She went out and got the food from the car, and she comes in and throws it all at the manager.
Yeah.
I mean, every bit of it, just throws it all at him. So do you think the manager should have held his composure and said, you for throwing the food at me. I really appreciate that. We'll be with you shortly. Or do you agree that the manager throwing the blender at her and knocking her out, and she was down for the knockout and lots of injuries she received. So what do you think was the right thing to do?
Hey, so, okay. Here's the thing. Now, can you imagine? I want y'all to put yourself in this woman's shoes. Yeah. As I said earlier, with the McDonald's experience. So she got the four kids in the car.
Yeah.
And, you know, she ordered these Happy Meals expecting the stuff to be right. And evidently...
Well, I mean, you want your stuff to be right. I mean, it's only... This is why
you pay your hard-earned money.
This is why those people get paid to do what they do. And it may not be a lot of money, but they agreed to get paid.
Yeah.
They agreed to work there, so... you know,
and to me, it won't even matter. Like, if you're like from the customer perspective, mm-hmm. you don't care at that moment how much those workers at the McDonald's are getting paid at that moment. You just know that you paid your money
right.
for what you ordered, and you want it to be right.
Yeah,
and if
yeah,
it's
absolutely.
So blatantly wrong, that's going to make you kind of angry.
Yeah, I can see that, but I have been to McDonald's before, and the fries, yeah. Whenever I eat their fries, and it's hot, it's good. But I cannot stand it when you go to a restaurant or a fast food restaurant,
yeah.
eat their fries, and it's cold. You can tell like it's, have you ever gotten fries from McDonald's and it seemed like it's been sitting there forever and they just decided to give it to you or something?
Yeah.
Or it belonged to someone else and they didn't want it and then it's sitting out and they put it in your bag or something?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how it goes. I'm just saying, I have had some bad service from McDonald's. And I'm not a big fan of McDonald's. Really, I'm not. But if you're going to get anywhere, I don't care if it's from a steakhouse or Longhorns or wherever. We've eaten there too. But, you know, you expect to have good service. You expect the food to be, you know, well done. You expect it, or whatever you want. If you want a steak, medium rare, you expect it to be the way you want it. And this is why they do what they do. Now, this lady didn't get her food the way she wanted it, and she clowned out. I mean, she just, you know, just tell the truth. She acted clown.
Yeah, she turned up.
Yeah, whatever you want. She turned up, but she was knocked down.
That's true. But now, let me say this, though. Is it really... Now, I wouldn't do that. Don't get me wrong. You know, ain't nothing in the world where I'm going to throw food at somebody. I do think that's messed up. Now, and even in the video, she seemed like she ain't really apologize for doing that, you know. But let's put yourself in... Not only was the order wrong, but she went back and what did she do? She talked with the people... Reasonably, you saw the video.
Right,
she was talking for a while, and then they told her to hold on. We're gonna get right to you. We're mm-hmm. gonna get right to you. 25 minutes passed by.
Right,
you're standing in the line watching all these other people.
Your food at that point is no longer good.
Yes, and that's why she went out to her car and said, "You know what? Instead of trying to fix it, here, just give me my money back." And they still ignored her. So, you can't tell me that wouldn't make y'all angry.
Yeah, but, yeah. You know, I mean.
Because, you know, especially, it makes it worse when people are doing it on purpose.
I think she tipped the scale.
Yeah.
Unbalanced it anyway when she threw the food at the manager.
But being real, what I'm saying is, if you see somebody intentionally ignoring you and disrespecting you.
Right. Well,
come on now. You already messed up the food.
Now
then you got their money.
Right. Now you learned the lesson at that McDonald's. Don't go there no more.
Yeah, yeah.
Unless they do something. But they should have given her. I agree. They did give her the runaround.
Oh, no doubt.
And I think one person here said the manager was fired. Is that what you're saying?
Well, Greg says probably why they couldn't read. Manager for comment because she was fired.
Okay. The manager was dead wrong and should be arrested and sued. Wow, Greg.
Definitely.
Yeah, well, okay.
You broke my eye with a blender.
Yeah, I agree. You know, the manager, her response was wrong and negative, and it does not represent policy, I'm pretty sure. To throw a blender at someone, and then, I mean...
She could have lost her eye.
Yeah, but I guess,
that's
I don't major. Know.
That ain't no joke.
I don't know. The food thrown at the manager, the way it was thrown, the manager probably, you know, it seems to me that the manager had enough of this lady, and then she came in, and the manager ignored her.
Mm-hmm.
The manager seems like, to me, she was already ticked off of even being there in the first place. That's why she ignored her. And then to come down and then to the lady bring the food in after so long of a time being ignored by the manager and the employees, she brings her food in. It didn't help her when she started throwing the food across the counter. That did not help.
Well, yeah, and I agree.
I mean, if somebody punches you, you know, what are you going to do? Stand there and say, okay, well, hit me again. Whoa, that felt good.
Well, here's the thing.
By her throwing those burgers and fries at that manager, do you think the manager felt good and really appreciated that? But now here's the other thing. She works for a company. She's got to be professional. Even though the lady threw her food at her, and at that point, she's, should have went ahead and gave her the money and to get her on out of there. Just, you know, move her along. Because the more you hang around with that, and I'm pretty sure they lost some customers by her ignoring the lady and the lady acting her food in the lobby.
Yeah.
So the best thing
matter
probably...
Matter of fact, the lady said that people walked out. They
yeah.
Came in.
Yeah, but and the best thing at that point, give her her money back and then let her go and so it wouldn't cause any more disturbance or anything and make you look bad right there in your presence. So, but at any rate,
well, look,
the lady had a busted eye, swollen eye, busted yes. cheek, and stitches
broken.
And all of that stuff. And so
broken bones in her face.
Yeah, I mean, but, you know, this goes to show you, when you go to places like that and you act a fool, I mean, you never know what you're going to get.
Well, it's expect consequences.
I mean, because this lady come in and then she threw the food at the lady, but she didn't expect anything in return like this, which there should not have been. But you don't go in and then just say, okay, you know, you people are dogs. This is what I think of you
no,
people.
No, I agree with you.
And throw the food at folks, and then
I agree with
you just never go know what kind of response now, you're going to get. That's what I'm saying.
I got you. Now, let me read some of your comments real quick. Greg said, this is not where this video is from. It's from some other city. But when Keller was naming that address to that particular McDonald's, Greg said, that's Walker Holmes in the dirty South Memphis.
Oh.
And Greg also says she caught a Mac black eye. A Mac black eye. Yeah, that's a new item on the menu. Mm. Right there. GKP said, I'm from Walker Homes. Okay. So you and Kelly know the same area.
Well,
there.
Kelly said the food, the service.
Everything.
You name it, everything was nasty. I mean, was not right there. But I said nasty.
Oh, man.
Okay.
And let's see here. And that goes to Gravel says good morning. And then the comments you just read there. So, y'all let us know what you think, man, if you got any more comments. Cause that
Greg says, no buts, Bob. Arrested and sued.
Yeah. Look, I mean, if that happened to me, look, sue them for everything they got.
Yeah.
But you'll be sitting on top of a gold mine.
Well, yeah, McDonald's is certainly a gold mine. But
that's like slipping and falling in the lobby. Yeah.
That type of behavior, though, out of a manager, is not. Well,
do y'all know a blender is a dangerous weapon?
What I'm saying is they hire managers.
Yeah.
To stop. And then for her to respond, you know. Even an employee should not respond that way.
Oh, no.
And especially a manager over the store and over the employees to behave in such a manner. I know it gets hard when people come in and throwing food at you. It's not easy.
I don't feel no sympathy for that because, look, a French fry is not going to bust your eye orbital bone in your face. Even though the burger is fried hard sometimes.
Okay, you don't feel sympathy for who? The manager?
Yeah, no, not at all.
Because, okay, the
food. Well, one, the food was bad. And then two, the lady was waiting for 25 minutes and you ignored her. So guess what? You know, and I'm not saying people should do that, but you can't push everybody like that and think they're not going
to
do anything.
Yeah, because you never know who's in your business. And to do something like that, it's... 901-213-6020 if you'd like to call in and talk to us, or you can leave a message as you're leaving them on Facebook. And yes, go ahead.
Kelly said manager was definitely in the wrong in this situation.
Oh,
and GKP says sitting on top of the golden arches. You'll be sitting right on top of that old sign
now,
you know, owning that place.
Now let me ask this question. Do you think this lady that threw that blender, did she commit a crime?
Yes.
Did she commit a crime? No. Did she actually commit a crime throwing this blender at her, or it was just an act of a bad manager at McDonald's, and she should not be held accountable as far as a crime or like go to jail or arrested for throwing a blender? You know, like she shot somebody.
It is
not like she was out in the public and she, you know, saw somebody walking across a parking lot or something and shot somebody, or somebody got into an argument, or somebody shooting on the freeway, or somebody robbing a bank or something like that. I mean, this lady just threw a blender.
Just threw a blender. Yeah. Look, if you're walking down the street and somebody throws a blender in your face, well, you're going to jail.
That's different. I mean, but this lady is on the job.
Yes, that's worse.
That other, you know, if you're outside on, you don't, I mean, that's just two people that's a fight.
Yeah.
But, I mean, at this manager, I don't know. Well.
Oh, my goodness. Look, think about it. A blender, if you saw...
But I'm not saying it's right.
No, I know.
I'm not saying it's right.
I know that. But here's the thing. If you saw the way that blender bounced off her face...
Yeah, it did. It hit her pretty hard.
Blenders are not something that bounces. And that thing bounced off her face across the counter.
Mm-hmm.
Like a rubber ball, meaning she got popped good.
Yes,
she like did. That person reared back and fired that thing.
Yeah,
like a quarterback, you know, throwing a football. So, I mean, that, come on now.
All right, folks. I guess that goes to show you, when you go just because you feel like, okay, you people work for me, give me my food and treat people wrong and all that other kind of stuff, cussing and going on and
yeah.
And, you know, hey, you better be careful, because those people work there are people, too.
Yeah,
and
that's true.
And they come from their home like you come from yours.
They come from Walker Homes.
And they still on the streets. You know, they're human like you. So when you, you know,
look,
bark at them, they might bark back a little louder.
Some of them come from Walker Homes, Dixie Homes,
yeah,
North Memphis.
Is there
Scudderfield or something?
Is it possible that someone at McDonald's could throw grease on someone?
I mean, they could throw.
Is there grease back there? Oh yeah, fries. They fry them in some grease or oil. But that was. I'm not insinuating anything, folks. But what I'm saying is these type things can happen or possibly can happen. That's why you have to be careful when the way you go in and the way you talk to people.
I'll ask you this before we move on. Who really started it though? Did McDonald's start it by not providing adequate service?
Well,
and then leading to the woman coming in? Because look, she didn't come in fries and bags immediately.
No,
it took her 30 minutes of waiting.
It started when they served her bad food.
Yeah.
And they knew. And I believe these employees and these managers at these places, I believe they know they're serving bad food sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
You know how long those fries have been out there on that thing.
Yeah.
You know those fries were not hot, and you knew those fries were not fresh.
Mm-hmm. You knew that box was cold.
And you knew that quarter, what did they have, quarter pounders there?
Yeah, yeah.
You knew that quarter pounder, with cheese or without it,
yeah,
was cold when you gave it to her. And you knew the bread was stale.
You knew those nuggets were no good.
Yeah. And then, you know, but hey, here it goes again. The customer comes in, even though it's wrong, food is wrong, you can't go in throwing things at people and expect nothing to happen. You know, just say, hey, I dare you do something to me, I'll have your job. Well, you may have their job, but they may have, like what happened here with this lady, her face got busted open, her eye was swollen by a blender.
Well,
so you got to be careful about that, folks.
I'm going to ask y'all this quick question. If y'all were working at McDonald's and in the situation, the position of a manager in this situation, right? Because we talked about putting yourself in the woman's shoes, but what about the manager? So I'm going to ask y'all this. If you're the manager and you get some fries and some boxes of Happy Meals and Big Macs thrown in your face by a customer, what is your response going to be? Y'all leave that in the comments or call in and let me know. Yeah. What's your response? You got somebody cussing you out.
Probably would be different, but at the same time.
Well, would it be different? I mean, if it ain't different, be real. We won't arrest you, you know.
Now, what I'm saying is there are going to be different comments by different people because different people behave in different ways.
Yeah.
But, you know, I don't know what kind of way they would. I don't think anybody on here would say I would throw the burgers and fries at her, you know.
No, I'm saying.
Or jump over the counter or whatever.
No, I'm talking about them as the employee. You get what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. I'm saying put yourself in the manager's shoes.
Mm-hmm.
If you get the burgers and fries thrown at you, right, and you work at McDonald's, what would your response be?
Well, I don't think they.
And I'm not just
I don't think McDonald's and Burger King or any place of employment would tell you to retaliate against the customer.
Of course not. But I'm like, look, everything in about the rule book. Most of these folks. Anyway,
yeah.
You know, it don't matter. Like, I'm just curious. See, I knew somebody was going to say it. GKP said, I'm throwing a blender at you.
Come on. Well, I mean, you know, you being for real. I mean,
that's what I'm saying. That's, you know. Well, ain't got to be politically correct right here from McDonald's and Burger King, man. Give me a real answer. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, so there's another blender being thrown right there.
Yeah.
Okay, it all depends on where he hits the customer.
Yeah. Jet says, you'll have my job. You'll have my job, but I'll have your. Oh, see, there you go.
Yeah. Okay. All right. 901-213-6020. Hey, yeah, another news.
Yeah, but y'all keep leaving comments on that.
Mm-hmm.
Cause we got to rush through too much, yeah. You know. But go ahead.
All right. Maggots. Maggots. Found in cafeteria food. Maggots found in cafeteria food in Southwind. And the health department found nothing when they came back to inspect. Josh, that's terrible. Maggots. If you've ever seen maggots, that's disgusting. And it's found in cafeteria food? I mean, so what's going on with this story?
Yeah, so Southwind High School is the location. And some people may know Southwind, you may not. I think a lot of people do, though. Southwind High School. A lot of complaints are going on about Southwind and their lunch. Because anytime you get maggots in your food, I'd imagine that's a good reason to complain. And it's ironic, you got a food theme here when it comes to food complaints. Now, McDonald's didn't have any maggots going on. So that's one thing you can say about that. But can you imagine, you know, in one of the situations that you're going to hear about.
Maggots, Jet. Maggots.
Yeah.
Maggots.
One of the situations.
He wants to know, what did I say? Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, you know what? I think he did say something about that, actually. But, man, this is an insane story you're about to hear. Locally. In the area, maggots found in the food, and you're going to hear the response from the parents and the student in question, or students in question that experienced the situation. And not only maggots, but undercooked food as well.
Yeah, raw.
Raw. You know how dangerous that is?
Yeah.
And these folks are supposed to be nutrition professionals here. You know, come on, man.
GKP says, I'm feeling like Bob didn't like our responses. What would you do, Bob? All capital letters.
Mm-hmm.
Offer them a sermon? I probably would.
Yeah, yeah.
I probably would. Not a sermon per se, but, you know, I would say something that would really make them think, really. Probably try to say something that would make them really think twice. Why did I throw that? Because sometimes you don't know the people that you're meeting in public. You don't know who they are. You don't know their profession. You don't know what their background is.
Yeah.
You know, you throwing stuff at folks, and that's just like somebody going to another business or a store, and then they see somebody there, and a person bumps into them. and then they just cuss him all out and say everything and ready to start something and don't even realize they talking to a evangelist or a prophet or whatever. They just, you know, so that's why we have to be careful in our responses and how we respond to people and, you know, for little stuff. So, but anyway, I but I wouldn't throw the blender at him. No.
Look, I think most of us would be, you know.
But now we got to realize now, GKP, I'm in the flesh just like you are.
I mean, come on.
You know, hey.
I mean, it's just like somebody come up and slap you in the face.
I get a headache just like you do sometimes. I'm human.
I'm telling you.
But
hey, y'all still give your answers on that too, because that's my question. I kind of just thought about that.
But anyway, the maggot story.
Yes.
What's going on with the maggots in the food? And it looks nasty at Southwind.
Yeah,
the only thing I remember about Southwind, it's been years and years ago,
mm-hmm.
when we went for a school out there in that area for you to go to school, and we went to, I think, Southwind Middle.
Okay.
It was a brand new school at the time, I think. One of those schools was a brand new school. It was a long time ago. Good area.
Yeah.
And, you know, but I have been really back out there. I think I've been back out there maybe twice to that area out there since. But at any rate, what's going on with the maggots?
Well, here's the maggots. Here's a picture right here. And that is of a sausage and biscuit. And you see those white things?
Oh, yeah.
That's what that is. So okay. I'm going to play the story, and these pictures will be the backdrop.
You'll see the graphics.
Yeah. You see it now, but I'm going to play the audio for you.
Of the maggots. Yes.
Here we go.
They're moving, folks. Okay. Here we go. Take a listen.
To find her breakfast was infested with what appears to be maggots. The picture was taken at Southwind High School Monday. It is now raising concerns about school lunches. Fox 13's Jackie Massey spoke to a student's mother about the lunch. And Jackie, this is not the only complaint out there about the school's food, but we should indicate that is one side of the story.
That's right, Merle. In fact, I was told that a day after that complaint was made about the suspected maggots in the food, another student was served undercooked chicken. That's what he is telling me. And now I know that two of these students have decided not to eat at the school anymore because they're worried about their health.
She had three maggots in it. She bit into it. That's when she opened it up and realized that something was in it.
Tiffany Williams almost threw up when her sister sent her this picture Monday morning. If you take a close look, you can see what appears to be maggots on the sausage biscuit.
So they're moving.
They were moving. Yeah, they were moving.
Williams says she's made complaints about the food at Southwind High before. Just one day after the maggot fiasco, she says her son was served undercooked chicken.
Somebody's child is going to either get food poisoning or something is really going to happen to them if they do not take action at Southwind High School in their cafeteria.
Williams made her complaint to the school Tuesday, but Fox 13 found out Shelby County health inspectors were looking into the maggot complaint Monday, hours after her sister found maggots inside her food. In the report, it says no food was contaminated. Williams says that's hard to believe and says she knows she isn't the only parent making complaints.
If your kids go to Southwind, you know your kids come home hungry. They come home hungry because the first thing they say, the cafeteria food is not right and I'm not eating it.
Out to Shelby County telling me they're giving me a statement soon, but I did receive a statement from the Shelby County Health Department about 30 minutes ago. They tell me they inspected the food on Monday and that they did not find any insects or any contaminated food items and that they'll be going back to the school for the routine checkup soon. Reporting live, Jackie Massey, Fox 13.
Wow. Nasty. And I know Greg in pest control.
Yeah, he's.
And Greg, I know you probably seen some things, and but man, maggots. I mean, you know, anything is filthy, but maggots,
yeah,
especially in food. And this girl took a bite of the food. Oh my goodness, that's just like, oh, I don't know. Is it like eating worms or something? I don't know.
I don't want to. Oh, my goodness.
I mean.
Oh, man. Look. And, yes. And y'all still see the pictures as I'm flipping through as we talk. And look at that. First of all, it looked like a sausage biscuit.
It doesn't. That's what I. Sausage biscuit?
That's supposed to be a sausage patty there. And, right. That's disgusting. And then the chicken nugget. I don't know if y'all saw the chicken nugget there.
Yeah.
With the raw.
Did they have a piece of fried chicken or something too?
Well, that was.
Oh, that's sausage biscuit.
Yeah, but the other thing was the chicken nugget where you see the boy's fingers.
Right.
And the chicken was undercooked. It's either chicken nuggets or pieces of a piece of chicken that he's holding up to the camera.
It's raw. Look inside. It's
pink.
Oh, goodness. This is disgusting, folks. This is, you know, people get paid to do this. Disgusting. Greg, I have seen some things loud.
Hey, it's funny. Before that, when you were talking about that, he said, maggots are the one thing I have never gotten used to in the 16 years of doing pest control, says Greg. So I can understand that. Because, you know, that's one of those things. It's just the way they look, you know.
Well, what would you see maggots in other than food, though? I mean, where else, Greg, would you find maggots in a house? I mean, I'm just saying.
Other than the garbage can outside.
Yeah. I don't know.
Call from
James.
James, welcome to the show. Good morning on a Thursday.
What's up?
What's up with you, bro?
All right. How you doing, sir?
Chilling. Hey, can you put that picture back up?
Yeah, which one? About any of them?
Yeah, the one with the so-called the nuggets.
Yeah, there okay. It is. I know it'll be a little delayed, but what you think about it?
Oh, gosh.
Man, you see it once again. I'm gonna be on the other side, man. Yeah. Look at that thumb.
I knew why did I know you were gonna bring that up? I knew you were gonna bring up the boy nails.
Oh God. You know what? I didn't see that until you brought it up.
He done ate more off that thumb than there.
Oh man! So,
but still, James, that does not cover for the fact that you can look in that chicken nugget or whatever it is and see some raw meat there, even though he did bite off of his finger. Maybe
I mean he probably missed, you know.
Yeah, but he didn't miss. Yeah. He didn't miss too much. There's a bite in that nugget in his hand too.
Yeah.
Look, I understand being poor, you know. And all of that, but I had to. If you're a parent, man, and you know the kids don't like the food or something, why don't you feed them? I mean, like as a parent, why don't you give them? Why don't you make them a lunch instead of whining about what the cafeteria is? Why do Negroes always want to beg all the time? I'm just saying, that's all they do is beg. And
whoa! I mean, so what do you mean beg? You talking about this is probably free lunch or something?
Yeah, okay, it's a free lunch. You don't like it, make them a lunch.
Yeah, well, you got a point there.
Instead of begging, I'm just saying, she's sitting up there begging.
Yeah.
Well, the school's
supposed to...
The school is supposed to supply
James,
healthy regimen.
There's maggots in the food, James.
But then don't eat it.
Even though some of the kids may not eat the food, but it's not. It doesn't make it right for them to not be able to make the food healthy and presentable and cooked right and not have maggots and stuff.
Why not? I mean, look, man, I'm on a different side. You don't like the food, bring your own lunch. Now, if you don't want
I agree with you. If you don't like the food, bring your own lunch. And sometimes your lunch can be better than some of the stuff they do but cook school, at these cafeterias. I used to love to take lunch to food.
That's
to
true. School. Homemade food, you know. But what if the parents can't cook, first of all? You don't even know if the parents got maggots in their food. Oh,
that has nothing.
Be bringing maggots to school.
But still, that's a big risk here with all these other people, our kids out there. And then you got maggots in the food. I mean, come on, that's nasty, James.
That's terrible.
And look, you know, hey. you try to fix it, but if you're a responsible parent, you would say, hey, look, I got to make my own kids' lunch and stuff. And when the woman said the stuff about how, like, the school is supposed to, you know, like, do this and that, I don't get that part because they're not. I mean, they're people just like her.
Okay, what do you mean the school's not what?
School doing their best, man. I mean, you know, they're doing their best. So what? You know, some flies got in the food. Okay, big deal.
Okay,
kick it out.
So you're saying if it's this one time and then people making a big deal out of this one time, it'd be different if it was something going on a consistent basis.
No, I'm just saying stop begging, man. Why don't you just make your own lunch? Stop begging. I just get sick of Negroes begging. They always begging.
See, I think, James, I think you're getting people on your – I think you're getting people to disagree with you here because these people, that's what they're there for, to cook the food and make sure it's healthy.
Nutrition
specialist. You know, and not to serve food with maggots in it. How would you feel if you went out to eat and you cut into your steak and then you see these little worms or maggots or whatever they're called flowing out of
I would have a problem with it because I'm paying for it. If I'm over here, expecting someone to feed me, and they handed me a plate of maggots and stuff like that, what am I gonna do? Complain? Or I'm gonna get up and leave? I'm gonna say, well, I need to go get my own food, man, because I can't eat this.
Yeah. Okay. So
that's what I don't get, man.
So you really hadn't spent anything. So if a person hadn't spent anything on something, you're saying they don't need to complain. Just if they don't like it, get up and go buy their own stuff.
Yeah, okay. That's what they should be teaching the kids that. They should teach those kids, look, that cafeteria is dirty. Don't eat that stuff. I'm going to prepare you a meal. Don't even worry about it. Let them fix whatever, you know, but I'm going to fix your food. Teach the kids to grow up knowing that they got to be responsible for themselves. Mm-hmm. But, of course, Negroes who always got their hands out begging. That's why they wind up on crack and messed up all the time. They ain't what they feel sorry for. No, wait a minute, bro.
James is serious. James,
I know.
He's serious.
Go ahead, James.
No, so that's why they wind up messed up on crack, whining, trying to get somebody to feel sorry for them about them. That mentality. Now they're going to sit there and whine. Well, then why don't you fix them some food? Mm. Yeah, it's wrong that there's maggots in the food. That's wrong.
Okay.
But why don't you fix them some food?
Okay.
Instead of begging, well, I wish y'all would do right. Well, they ain't going to do right.
So, James, it sounds like to me you're against the free lunch thing.
I ain't got no problem with free lunch. I just hate the mentality of people who begging and then complaining. Stop begging.
So, basically, it's like an entitlement that you feel is going on. All right. Well, I got it, James.
We all may not agree, but...
And that's how they end up on crack.
Yeah, well... James hung up on that. Thanks for the call, James. I mean, you know, if you want to call back, you're welcome to. But James hung up on you. He hung up on you at that point, Josh. All right, 901-360-20... Greg, I don't know, man.
I don't know either. James off the chain this morning. Greg. Even yesterday, he was off the chain yesterday. But
yeah. James has been off the chain here lately.
Yeah.
I mean, we hadn't heard from him
it's
in
been
a while.
He comes back like a house on fire.
Like a storm.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, so what do you think, folks? Do you think people that are on free lunches or getting lunch from the school, do you think they need to be complaining? That's what James is talking about here. I mean, you know, if you don't like the food, you're getting it free. And he said these Negroes, is, that's what he said. So, but complaining about nothing, they don't need to be learning the process of getting something for nothing, I think is what he was trying to say.
Yeah.
You know, free lunch and all, it's something for nothing. And they need to be taught that they need to earn their way. And, you know, if they want some food, if they want want food and don't want maggots in it, then buy their own stuff and then they'll make sure that there are no maggots in it.
I mean, look, technically, that's always correct. But here's the thing. The school, that's your job, man. You ain't got too much other stuff to do. If you can't do that, I don't know what to say. You can't. I mean, we're not even telling you to cook five-star meals. We're not even telling you to be Collierville and have a doggone restaurant for your kids, like the school down there. Just don't put maggots in it. How hard is
that? Well, I'm saying the maggots probably get in the food because it's spoiled over a period of time. And probably because the refrigeration in the school is not, the temperatures and stuff are not right on those type of things. And where has the health department been on all of this? Where have they been on all of this? They said they would come back and re-inspect again, but they didn't find anything. Do you think the health department came out and covered the school on this and told them, hey, turn your freezers up, or this freezer, replace this one before we have to come out again? We come out the next time, we'll give you a good grade, you know, and try to cover for you. But should the health department, if they are trying to cover for this particular school, should they do that? Because, they should tell the truth in a health inspection, because someone could get sick, very sick, from eating food that's, you know, just like this.
Yeah, you're right.
And the process, what James was talking about, you know, yes, they get free, I guess they'll get free lunches at some of these schools. I don't know. But if they do, then...
if you're on the assistance program.
The assistance program?
Yeah, whatever they call it. Okay. You know, where you sign up for free lunch.
Free lunch, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, but still, if the school agrees to give them free lunch, then the food still needs to be prepared right.
Greg said, "Ooh, James must have had dinner with Unforgetful yesterday."
Unforgetful? Boy, I hadn't heard of Unforgetful. Yeah. Shout out to Unforgetful. I hadn't heard from him since we've been on our own thing here.
I know he doesn't have internet. So.
Oh, yeah. He's one of those that not into technology.
Man, yeah. I wish if anybody had a contact for him, y'all let us know.
Unforgetful. Cool. We can contact him, or you can contact him for us, or let him know. Let him know where we're at. And he said, Greg said, yes, I have seen some things. Law, I read that. That's disgusting, GKP says. And I was trying to be nice, James.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say
that. You can't read the rest
of it. I can't read the rest of it. Greg says, in rats and mice. Did you read that?
I didn't, actually.
In rats and mice that have caught.
I got and in food products such as grain products, maggots are the larva of several different types of bugs. I know you put bigs, but you mean bugs.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, Greg, are you saying that you can get maggots in the cereal?
See, now y'all gonna start messing with me. Y'all, you're gonna mess with my mind now.
I mean, get maggots in cereal, boxes of cereal? And because if that's the case, when I'm pouring out my Raisin Bran, and am I pouring out maggots too? Then putting it in the milk and eating it and thinking that those are a part of the probably some other kind of raisins or something? I mean, I don't know, but I guess if cereal or anything sets up for a long time, over a period of time, then I guess it can. I don't know. Can it get maggots in cereal?
Lord.
Probably Greg don't know that. He says, what in the world is wrong with him today? Yeah, okay. Okay, laughing is, yeah. James, no, they shouldn't just allow that food to be like that. My children paid for their lunch, but I'd still complain
whether they ate it or not.
That's it. And I agree. James returned with a blast.
You can say that again.
Yeah. GKP says, D, James.
Lean on me.
Lean on me.
You smoke crack, don't you? Yeah. That's what he said to them.
Whoa.
I got to find that. You remember Lean On Me? He said that to the little boy.
Yeah.
You smoke crack, don't you?
Did he say that?
Yeah.
Call from
Greg.
Greg, welcome to the show. Good morning. Greg. On a Thursday.
You don't smoke crack, do you, Greg?
Good morning.
Don't answer that, Greg. Don't answer that.
I am
I don't think you. I
have no words for that.
I'm sorry he asked. Greg, I'm sorry he asked that question.
Well, Greg, hold on. I need somebody to hear this because I had to bring it up. Here it is.
Go on.
I want to jump.
Yes, you do. Crack, don't you? You smoke crack. Look at me, boy. Don't you smoke crack.
Oh, my God.
Mr. Clark was rough, boy.
He was rough, boy.
Man, James was on one this morning for sure. Man. He was on one. Man. I rarely ever use the word maggot. I just call them creepy crawlies because they just, you know, have induced many nightmares through the years, you know.
Creepy crawlies.
Yeah, I call them creepy crawlies,
okay.
Man.
All right, did you hear my question about the cereal? Can maggots get in can they produce themselves in boxes of cereal?
I don't know if I want to know.
Well, no, they don't produce themselves, but there's a type of bug. There are several type of bugs, right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
That, you know, that infest grain products. It's possible. I found some. This is about 3 years ago in a box of raisin bran.
Did you?
Yeah.
Not
in my house. I was searching for one of my customers had a particular type of bug, and you know, I knew. You know where to look for them in the grain products, and you know that's where I found them was in the grain products. Now, goodness. She wasn't seeing them; she was seeing the adults.
The adults, which are the flies, right?
Well, no, not flies. These were beetles.
Beetles. What are? Wait a minute. Oh. What are beetles?
Oh, you know beetles.
Beetles.
The little black bugs.
Let him.
All beetles start out as maggots.
Okay.
I didn't know that, though. Wow.
Okay, yeah, so
they all do.
Okay, so what is a beetle?
Beetle, you have, I mean, there's so many types. Like June bugs. June bugs are beetles.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, that's June like bugs are beetles. Or those brown beetles people everybody see in the summertime. Mm-hmm. The little black beetles that you see in your yard sometimes they come in the house. And they all start out as maggots, you know. Ooh. But most people associate maggots with flies, and that's it. But no, uh-huh. There's so many different types. I mean, even a caterpillar is basically a maggot with legs. Now, that's Ooh. Basically what it is.
Wow.
You know.
I look at them the same.
Greg, I mean, you know. So from now on, when I go to the grocery store, somebody to get me some raisin brands, I'm going to make sure they check the date on that and make sure it's up to date and it's put on the shelf. Because I'm not going to eat anything. Huh?
I said, well, you know, that always helps, you know. That helps.
Yeah, I mean,
but, you know, people fish with maggots. Waxworms is a maggot, so, you know.
I mean, good grief. I mean, you know, the fish can eat them, but not me. No,
I don't know, man. But
that's gross.
That's amazing that this is our bug and maggot education segment on this Thursday morning.
And you all will get a bill for this information, so, you know. I just want y'all to know that.
I'll just say something nice about you, Greg.
put it on.
Hey, I'm going to say this. Greg is treacherous. The buzz, boy.
Yeah, nah.
I mean, boy, I mean, if you get come to check something out, you ain't going to see him no more. And I mean,
passing.
No more. Yes. Not no more, but no more.
No more.
But anyway, Greg, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm a student of my craft. I just say that, you know. But, man, look, that situation at McDonald's, manager should have just gave the woman her money back. Yeah. First of all, she should have just ignored her. The manager shouldn't have just ignored her the way she did.
Yeah, you know? I agree.
You would let someone throw fries and burgers all in your face?
Well, I don't know about let them, but, you know. I would have never let it get that far along anyway.
Yeah.
You know, because it's just that, you know, when somebody come in and they got to complain about, you know, your wares, you know, you jump on there. That's priority at that moment. Yeah. That is the absolute priority at that moment, mm-hmm. right? Because everybody knows in retail, in any aspect of retail, everybody knows that one negative comment would go way farther and spread to more people than any positive comment. So that's the first train of thought right there.
Yeah.
So anytime somebody come in and they want a refund, you inspect the food, make sure it's there, you know, make sure they have 80% of it. You know, if they want their money back, you just give them their money back and be done with it.
Mm.
Yeah. Now, I understand sometimes why they, you know, try their best not to, because it hurts their I don't know what all the different places called it, but when I worked at like AutoZone and Advance Auto, you know, all your purchases add up to this average sale, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and you want that to be high as possible, right? So you that's why when you go to the places, they ask you to, do you want this and do you want that? Those are considered add-ons to a main sale,
right.
And it increases your ticket per hour, right?
Right.
So if you get somebody to come in and want to return something that's a pretty significant dollar, they do all they can not to, because that's going to bring that average down.
Gotcha.
You know, that's why a lot of times they book the system and try not to give them the money back and argue with them and stuff like that.
Because
I've seen it. I didn't know anything about that until I started working at AutoZone. And we had a gentleman, he came in and purchased three objects, came up to about over $300, right?
Right?
Well, lo and behold, he had to bring it back because it was the wrong stuff, right?
Mm.
So the manager, man, was trying his best to do everything not to give that man his money back. And I didn't know why he was fighting so hard until eventually he gave the guy his money back.
Right.
So, after he left, I was like, "What was that all about, man?" He was like, "Man, he's gonna bring my it was called CA at AutoZone. I forget what CA stands for, but it's the cash. I think it's called cash average or something like that."
Mm-hmm.
And so he's like, "Man, he's gonna bring my CA down and blah blah blah." So what's CA? He said, "Well, that's your blah blah blah. All the stuff you make per hour, it averages out, and you want it to be as high as possible." So by that guy bringing that $300 back, you know. And that dragged it all the way back down. So
that's,
I was like,
I didn't know
but still, it's not that daggone important.
Exactly.
You know, customer service is more important than that.
But, you know, the thing about it is, if you give the guy his money back and apologize and that type of thing, then, you know, the customer may come back.
Yeah, exactly.
You know,
that's the whole thing, right? That's the whole premise of it.
Yeah.
You want a repeat customer, not an angry or disgruntled customer, because they're probably not going to come back, and they're going to tell other people that they're not going to come.
Yeah, if you give them a hard time about giving them their money back, if you give me a hard time about giving me my money back, and I'm not satisfied with the product that I purchased from you, then I'm not coming back.
Definitely not.
I'm done with you. You know, that's just the way I am. But
that manager was dead wrong, and I don't know why she didn't file a police report about it.
Mm.
You know, the customer. I mean, I definitely would have. I mean, she still has time to, you know.
Well, that's a
good
point.
But I definitely would have.
Well, I almost wonder if it had something to do with the fact that she threw food also. Maybe. You know,
well,
now, it's not nearly, like I said, it's not to the level of a blender. But, you know, hey, I don't know if that's a charge or not.
That could have been it, but, yeah, regardless, you went to the hospital, you had surgery.
Yeah.
You know, so I would have definitely, me myself, I would have put the charge on him, you know.
Yeah, and
I would have.
Is it that, you know, she, like Josh said, she threw the food and hit the manager? And was that assault with food?
It didn't appear that she hit the manager. It didn't appear that she hit anybody with the food.
Yeah.
It didn't even look like it got close, but, you know. Yeah. I mean, I understand the indignity of it as the manager, somebody throwing some, you know, whatever it is at you or in your general direction, or, you know, directed at you, but. Man, I'm pretty sure she got fired, you know, very quickly after that.
Yeah, but that manager had to have been a baseball player or a football player or something, because she threw that thing with accuracy. I mean, force, a blender?
Can you imagine a blender bouncing
off your face? Boy, that hurt me thinking about that, Doug Gray.
And she got extra points because the woman went flat on her back.
Yes.
She got extra points.
I'm not trying to laugh. She was like, she was down like one of them. She took a punch from the former champ, Muhammad Ali.
When I first saw that video, I didn't even see the blender. I was like, what happened?
It's so fast, like a blur hit her in the face,
But the blender bounced back off her face on the other side of the counter. I said, man, that was a bump. But anyway.
That's crazy. But look, fellas, I got to run, man.
Yes, sir.
And I'll listen in as I can.
All right, Greg. Hey, we appreciate the call.
But James, man, you need to stay away from Unforgiveful, man. If you hanging out with Unforgiveful, man, you need to stay away from him.
I don't know about that. Yeah. Hey, we appreciate the call.
Like you said, James was on one. But I'll holler at y'all later, man.
Okay, man. All right. 901-213-6020.
If James is out there, I'm really curious his thoughts on this McDonald's thing as well as the rest of you. Now I know it's in the second hour, and we're gonna have to take a break.
And
when we come back, we could probably play the clip again if you want, or something else, whatever you want to do.
Yeah, and don't forget about Lotta Burger. I know I hadn't said anything in a few days. Mm-hmm. Lotta Burger, I think it's 2260. South Third. Folks, go out there and see the owner. She's the owner there. And
Kosa Thomas,
yes, and hey, I'm telling you, you want a big burger, you go to Lotta Burger, and you will get a lot of it, and they have other things there as well. You will play the commercial, you'll hear what they have there as well. They're open, what time they open, 11 o'clock?
Yes, 11 o'clock, and don't forget, also, well, actually, I believe 10.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, but I know.
Yeah.
To 11, stuff like that. So
You call, you can't call. You know, they're very, very busy after the 11 o'clock hour.
Yes, and what I wanted to bring up though, Lotta Burger is a legendary name in the city, and some people I've heard that grew up on Lotta Burger did not know it was still around, even after seeing the commercial.
Oh.
But it is around, and go by there. They're better than ever. Same old school burger, with the owners there, so they do a great job.
Well, the thing about it, Josh, is real hamburger.
Yes.
It's not that stuff they get at grab a freezer somewhere,
out of the
you
box.
Know, they have to come in.
Like McDonald's.
Or Burger King. And, you know, you don't know what's in that burger. You know, just throw it on the thing there and just cook it, and, you know, and put it on a bun or something. But at any rate, hey, go by there today and see Miss Kosa Thomas and Lotta Burger, 2260 South 3rd. Hey, don't settle for any burger. Get a Lotta Burger. We'll be back after this. You're listening to Talk Back Live with Bob.
And Josh.
9:13, 13 minutes past the hour of 9 o'clock Central Time. And a very pleasant good morning to you on a morning. We'll be back after this.
Yeah.
If you're looking for some of the best old-fashioned burgers and cakes in town, Lotta Burger is the place to go for all of your favorites. Lotta Burger, 2260 South 3rd, Memphis, Tennessee, 901-946-2001. They're open Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6:45 p.m., and the items on their menu include single double, triple burgers, Philly sandwiches, smoked sausage, beef hot dogs, grilled cheese, tenders, fries, onion rings, and more. Call-in orders must be done before 11 a.m. No calls accepted after 11 a.m. Drive-thru is available. Hungry for a burger? Lotta Burger, 2260 South 3rd, Memphis, Tennessee, 901-946-2001. Don't just settle for any burger. Get a Lotta Burger.
Graphic Printing, located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis. A complete print shop for all your printing needs. They do it all. Color copy, resume, funeral program, rubber stamp, full-color business cards, wedding and graduation invitations, and more. 30-plus years of quality work and service. They're open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-345-9294.
Are you tired of going to the doctor with the same issue over and over again and never getting any relief? Are you tired of buying all types of vitamins and supplements, hoping but not knowing for sure that they will keep you healthy? Or are you getting enough of the right kind of nutrients that your specific body needs? If you answered yes to any of these questions, you need a nutritional blood analysis. With a nutritional blood analysis, we can take one drop of blood from a prick of your finger and analyze your body's nutritional needs, nutritional deficiencies, and nutritional imbalances. This analysis can provide an early warning of possible future health challenges, so you can make the changes now to avoid the negative outcome. A nutritional blood analysis can be used to monitor a health challenge before and after adopting an approach to restore health and balance. It will also allow you the ability to determine the effectiveness of various approaches to restoring and balancing your health. So don't wait. Make your appointment. Stop guessing with your health. Know what works for sure. 901-602-7063.
CJ Used Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJ Used Appliances have the best prices in town, sales and service, heating and air, also the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever.
Hey, welcome back. All the way up. Welcome back to the show, Talk Back Live with Bob.
And Josh.
And it is now 9:18. 8 past the hour, 9 o'clock Central Time. And a very pleasant good morning to you on a... And, yes, sir. So starting your day off at 46 degrees under partly cloudy sky. Beautiful. Brisk, chili, all that other good stuff. Not chili, you know, on the hot dog. Yeah. But, you know, expect to get up around 6:30. We're high with chilly rain. Showers of thunderstorm moving into the area tomorrow. And so, do we need any more rain? Well, that's I guess. I don't know.
What I do know is that it's awesome outside.
It is. It feels very good.
Gotta love fall, man. It's,
yeah.
To me, the best time weather-wise of year.
Time to get the, well, some of the leaves that are falling off the big plants.
Starting to fall.
Yeah, starting to fall off some of the big plants in the yard. So have to get those things up to keep your yard looking good. I don't think we have to do any more cuts or grass cutting. Seems like everything is staying, you know, steady. The grass is not really growing that much, but I don't think I'll be getting another cut this year. So, but here come the leaves, and they're on the way. All right, 901-213-6020 is the number to call, and we're talking about maggots. Yes, in the food. That's nasty, folks. Mm-hmm. McDonald's customer down for the knockout.
Yeah.
And what round? Josh said it was the first round. She was in clowning and decided to throw the food. She didn't like the service she had. Throw the food. I don't know what she had. Fries, what, Big Mac?
Well, she had four Happy Meals.
Happy Meals. Okay, Happy Meals. Okay. And she threw all of that at someone over there. She was upset. Boy.
25, 30 minutes waiting.
Oh.
And being ignored. I think they were hoping she'd just leave.
Well, that's not good for a manager or any employee to ignore a customer. That's not good. And so this customer was already mad about the food. The served food wasn't good. Whatever was wrong with that order. And then, you know, she makes the customer wait. They make the customer wait on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
And so, wow, that's double jeopardy, you know. So anyway, 901-213-6020. In other news, to talk about.
Yes.
Trick or treat.
Okay.
Trick or treat. Which one are you going to expect this Halloween?
Well,
you going to expect a trick or you're expecting a treat? Trick or treat, age limit is 14 years old. Did you know that? I didn't know that till this morning.
Age limit?
I didn't know the limit. Well, I mean, you don't go out like me and Josh and all of you and other people. I mean, you don't go out at the age of 25 trick or treating, do you? I mean, you know. Some people may.
Honestly, I think there are some. Look, you know, love to get candy.
Other than the parents going with their kids.
Yeah.
I don't think it's appropriate for, or do you, at the age of over 20 years old, go trick-or-treating?
Look, a grown man going trick, or a woman trick-or-treating.
Yeah, but the age limit, they say, to trick-or-treating, there's a law.
Mm-hmm.
Age limit is 14 years old. I didn't know that.
Well, in some places, it is. And they're very strict about it. So, what I was reading about is that
You remember the guy on Sanford and Son? He said, I didn't know that. So,
yeah.
But anyway. But I really... Go ahead, Josh.
Yeah. And I didn't either. I thought this was something that all people could enjoy with happiness.
Yeah, I don't think adults, you know, I wouldn't enjoy going trick-or-treating. but there's an age limit. You at the age of 15, 14 is the age limit for trick-or-treating.
Yeah,
and it's
so,
against the law if you trick-or-treat over the age of 15.
Gotcha. And here it is. So okay. The city, and this is Chesapeake, Virginia.
Right.
The city bans anyone over 14 from trick-or-treating. The law was introduced after an especially violent Halloween in 1968.
Oh.
Offenders are subject to a spine-chilling fine of $250. While the fine sounds outrageous, the original 1970s ordinance was even more restrictive. It limited Halloween trick-or-treaters to age 12 and under at that time and threatened lawbreakers with jail.
Wow. So if you trick-or-treated over the age of 12 or whatever, they took you to jail. They arrested you.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Well, I mean, you know, I can see their point to relative to what probably went on, you know, because, you know, you
whatever
get some
situation.
Grown folks out there and some people of age, man, that are older, you know, not kids. I think, really, I'm surprised that 14 years old kids are allowed to trick or treat. You know, I always, I would always look at trick-or-treaters as somebody like, you know, 4, 5, 6.
A little bit of kids.
You know, age of 10, maybe.
Well, I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah.
Back in high school, I know plenty of folks that were junior seniors that really look forward to trick-or-treating still.
Oh, boy.
Now, some of them, you know, took their brothers and sisters out.
Yeah.
You know, and they were with them. But some of them were dressed up with their brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
Kind of used it as an excuse to get some more candy from
them. Wow. That is, I'd rather go buy it. I'd rather, you know, and I, you know, trick-or-treating is really gotten dangerous over the past few years.
Is it something that you think should go away?
I don't, you know what? I don't think it should go away. I don't, I'm not a celebrator of Halloween anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, because of our Christian heritage, our nature. You know,
yeah.
But I don't believe in goats and gobblers and all that other. You know, there are spirits.
Yeah.
There are evil spirits, and you can look at them as a friendly ghost if you want. And, you know, the devil put a trick on you. But, you know, no, there are people out there that probably at the age of 10 is probably the oldest age that would be able. No, I don't think. I think you can counter Halloween and make it holy, or whatever the case may be, and then celebrate it as a day you celebrate the Lord.
Well, my thing is, people are doing that,
but here's the thing. If you do that, then, you know, you could probably help lead other people to Christ. Now, here's the thing. I wouldn't do away with Halloween or the trick-or-treat. I would just, you know, in a neighborhood or a certain area of town, you know the people, just go to their home. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And then get candy that way. But especially if you live in a subdivision or an area where, you know, people know each other across the street or whatever, you know, you can, you know, they can, kids can go and that type of thing. Or they can have a little Halloween party at a church or a family or
which
a gathering,
a lot,
which happens, civic center. Which happens a lot, and then they could ditch out candy, bags of candy, and things of that nature, and have a good time, or maybe some games played or something. But the old-fashioned way of trick-or-treating and thinking that is okay, no. And I don't understand why do people put glass and razor. You know, I think that's the most evil thing that a person could do. Put a razor blade in an apple or in candy, or the kid can bite down on it. A razor blade. Do you know what a razor blade does? It is not a razor blade. Is not just a regular cut. It is a. It's an evil cut to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but
I mean, it's just evil. Like,
I mean, the blade of it though. To do that. And knowing that it might a kid's mouth up, and then not have a guilt about it, and then just sit back and then listen to it on the news, and then, you know, think and laugh at the whole deal. I don't understand what are people thinking. And then if you're listening by Facebook or our Spreaker app or however other way you're listening to us. Do you know of anyone that has went out trick-or-treating and got razor blades or glass or other things in candy and things of that nature? Or are you known or have been inspected some candy and things of that nature and found that there was something placed in the stuff that these people got from trick-or-treating?
So, and that question also, like, my thing, you know, with the whole trick-or-treating thing, do you think it's even worth still doing? Do you mind, like, if you got kids or if you got nephews, nieces, or whatever the case is, or cousins, do you still encourage them to go trick-or-treating? How does that process, you know, how do you think that should still be done nowadays? Because, man, people are so crazy, man.
Yeah.
Like, you know, a few years ago, I remember hearing about needles. Like some candy bars.
Right, needles.
Or some fruit that were some kids and some adults, which is why they say to inspect it if you can. Yeah. Which I'm curious how you even do that, like with a certain type of candy.
What are you going to do, break it up and, you know, and see if anything's in it? You know, I'd rather just buy some and, you know, and then have it, maybe some kids over that you know or something and have that you trust to be able to give bags and things. I'm sad that it have to be that way, but
you know, Walgreens.
That just goes to show you how people, how evil people are in the society and the times that we're living in.
I ain't gonna put nothing in there.
Yeah, you know? GKP, James told y'all to stop begging. He laughed out loud. In other words, buy your own candy. You like candy, don't you? Jay Clark? What is that? What is that? Oh, Jay Clark.
No.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, you're talking about Clark as Mr. Clark on the...
Yeah.
On Lean on Me.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, okay. But, you know, yeah, you know, in that sense, you buy your own stuff. And I've always done that. But, you know, I just don't trust the process anymore. And I think a lot of people have grown weary of that as well on trick-or-treating. Or have you? What do you think? 901-213-6020. Do you think?
Thing. Go on. Jump.
No, I don't want to jump.
Yes, you do. You smoke crack, don't you? You smoke crack, don't you? Look at me, boy. Don't you smoke crack?
Yes, sir.
You know what that does to you? Huh?
Yeah, and so that's dangerous too.
Yeah, I mean that's
not a Halloween.
No.
I don't know if that's a trick or a treat. That's not a treat, but it can be a trick to you.
Let's see, Terry left something here. It's a YouTube link. Please check out this story. Family outraged. Brother was shot dead for armed robbery.
Okay. We'll check that out. Maybe it may be something for another show.
Yeah, maybe another.
Okay.
Let me grab that.
Thank you, Terry, for that. And now, what do you think about trick or treat? Or did you hear the McDonald's story? The customer wasn't satisfied, threw the food at the manager or somebody, and then the manager threw a blender and knocked her in the eye, knocked her down for the count.
Unbelievable. Still unbelievable.
So, I mean, you know, I don't know. I guess whoever that was, the manager that threw that blender at the customer, hit her in the eye and busted her cheek underneath there. I mean, that manager must have, she grabbed that thing pretty quick. She must have grabbed the first thing she saw that was available and that wasn't nailed down that she could throw and knock this woman out. This woman on her gluteus maximus. Yes, she did. And, but folks, when you go into restaurants or wherever you go in public, don't go in clowning like this woman did and just threw her food at the people or at the manager. That's not going to get anything done. And then she ended up getting her face busted up and all that other kind of stuff. And, you know, I don't know. What do you expect people to do? For you to slap, they're going to stand there and say, okay, wow, thank you. People are not going to.
That's true. But I guess I'm saying, like, it's measures. It should be levels to the situation. If you throw a water bottle, you know, an empty water bottle at somebody.
Yeah.
And they say, okay, now I'm going to shoot you. That gives me the right to shoot you.
Well,
I'm
glad you brought that up. Some people will shoot you. If the fact that you attempted to throw something at them, you threw something at them to mean harm.
Yeah.
Even though it was an empty water bottle, but why did had a stone in it, a rock, a big rock or something in it, they probably would have threw it anyway. All they knew is that was all they had. And if it was more in that water bottle that a person might throw, then, you know, they would have thrown it. You know, so I think the the significance of it is that you threw something at me to for bodily harm. And even though it didn't have anything in it, but, you know, your purpose, your meaning behind throwing the stuff. And this lady at McDonald's threw all this food back at the manager and all of that, the fries. And it may have been stale, but there's a better way of handling it. And the manager just threw that blender and knocked her out in her face. And she was messed up for a while. But
I bet. I mean, good grief.
Is that the right and proper way to handle things, folks? You know.
Man, I mean,
you just don't do that. Robert, thanks for joining us today. Also, a lot of other people come in. John Jenkins.
John Jr. Jenkins.
Out of Milan, Tennessee.
In the building.
Yes, John Jenkins out of Milan, Tennessee. And he is a general manager of Subways up in the Milan, Humboldt, Trenton, Dresden, and Jackson and McKenzie and all that other kind of stuff. And I, if I'm not mistaken, I think John Jenkins up in one of his stores up there, I think he's doing some hiring. And so yeah, John Jenkins, very, very good, dear friend of mine. And man, they've been down to visit us and we've had some wonderful times together. And so we appreciate him and his wife and they're very, very good people. And so, hey, thanks for checking in with us, John. Jet says, do me a favor right now, please, Josh. Before y'all go off the air, look up how many real cases have there been of poisoned or razored candy, for real. That's a good thing. That's a good point to gain to look up.
Well, I have.
Okay.
Because I did see that comment there. So, all right, I'm looking here, and according to this article in the Washington Post, that they are talking about that most of this stuff is fear-mongering.
What do you mean by that? What do they mean by that?
Is that
this, it doesn't happen?
That this is largely unfounded, that it's happened. But that it is an over-exaggerated thing used to scare people during Halloween. I'm going to just read some of this.
I'd rather scare them rather than them biting down on a razor blade. I mean, I'm just, hey,
I hear
being for real.
It says a semi-viral Facebook post from Pennsylvania Police Department has become the latest example of an exhausting Halloween tradition. The spread of super scary but largely unfounded warnings about poisoned Halloween candy. This time, the police in Jonestown, Pennsylvania, warned people that, quote, drug-laced edibles are packaged like regular candy. It may be hard to distinguish from the real candy. Urged parents to check their kids' halls for edibles containing THC, the ingredient in marijuana that makes you high, it's essentially. Even though the post doesn't say that police believe anyone actually intended to hand out candy like this to kids. The Facebook post was picked up by a wave of local news outlets, then national, and echoed the department's warnings. Now, then people that enjoy THC came out and complained and said, hey, look, that stuff costs way too much money to be handing out to kids. So they're like, you know, the THC laced candy, it's too much money to be handing out for free. Like they say it's going to happen. So they claim that that's not a real thing.
Okay. All right.
Well, I mean, that's just what it's saying. And then it talks about the razor blades. And said that doesn't happen as much as they say it does. Now, I must say.
I don't know.
I must say.
But you can't take that chance anymore.
Yeah.
It was something that had started well back in the day.
Yeah. And it said in the 80s it was real prevalent.
And in the 70s it started too.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, it's, and it's been a tradition, meaning that it's still going on. It's still going on. So do you trust your kids to go to an unknown area and just start saying trick or treat? you know, and all this other kind of stuff. I mean, you know, you shouldn't. But
and you know what? And to be clear, now this article I'm reading, it's in the Washington Post, but it is an opinionated article. So it's not like it's a news report, even though they report some facts that are in there. Mm-hmm. And not to say they're lying, but this is what I mean. The way it reads is like they're saying that people are criticizing Halloween. You know what I mean? It's like, I don't know if you got something else you're trying to read.
I understand what you're saying. I wouldn't take it as people criticizing Halloween.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying that's what this person seems to be thinking. That people that...
And I think this person is narrow-minded.
No, I
mean, if there's danger out there to the kids, you know it's happening, it's been happening, and it's still happening. And it's not just people just hate Halloween or don't want to celebrate Halloween. It's just that, hey, you evil day, which is Halloween, people celebrate, and then people do evil things. So you have to take whatever measures you need to take to protect your child. Now, a person like this don't need to have children. You know, hey, they're just trying to do away with Halloween or say something bad about Halloween. I mean, you let your kids go anywhere and just, you know, that you don't need children. You know, you have to face reality. These things are happening. These things are for real. You know, and so you have to watch where your kids go if you're going to take them out trick-or-treating. Make sure they go to places of people you know, you can trust, and things of that nature. And I know it shouldn't be that way. It should not be that way. But you cannot trust the evil in this world and in some people. You just can't do it. If a person will take a gun into a bank and rob a bank, shoot two or three people, you better believe that person will put some poison or a razor blade in some candy if he had the opportunity.
That's true. You know, and I guess the thing is, you always got to take into account with the trick or treating thing. You're going over strangers' houses for the most part.
Yeah.
So I mean, come on now. So
yeah.
You know, as crazy as people are, you can't just completely dismiss it as folly. Yeah. Not to say that it talked about how some people have faked finding needles and their candy to get popular on social media. And that's, you know, people do
well,
stuff.
I don't know. I don't want to be popular that way.
No.
If I had got a needle, then, you know.
I'm saying they put it in their own candy bar.
No. I would not put anything in my own stuff. That's crazy. Some people may do that. They have problems.
Yeah.
But for the most part, that's just be honest and say, hey, there are evil people out there that do this stuff, and it's been going on for as long as we can remember. And you cannot trust people everywhere. You cannot trust everybody.
Ain't nothing wrong with taking precautions.
No, there's nothing wrong with that. And for this guy to say that you're doing this to try to stop Halloween, I mean, what is your concern?
How dare you stop Halloween?
I mean, you know, the thing about it is, you know, he doesn't have any concern for people. He's concerned about the holiday. It's not the kids eating poison candy or razor blades or needles in their candy. He's concerned about doing away with the holiday. Halloween. Crazy. Greg replying to Jet on one of the statements here, he said, there have been many, but lots of them have actually been either hoaxes or self-inserted harmful items.
That's Jet, right?
That's Greg replying to
Jet.
Oh,
I missed that comment. Okay.
Jet says, and poison Tylenol as well. Probably happened once in the 70s, but you think it has happened every year since the advent of medicine. You would think it, yeah.
Yeah, okay. And I see his last comment. His point is powerful. how powerful perception can be.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Because even like you said, I don't think it's been like huge, gigantic numbers of this stuff happening. Mm-hmm. But the few that has happened has fueled rumors for years. And I think it's less of a fear mongering and more
it used to happen a lot more back in the day.
But,
and there were times whenever you're from a small town,
yeah,
and then you hear people say, it comes on the news in that small town that hey, we had 50 cases or 100 cases of kids getting poison candy or razor blade candy or needles found in their candy over trick or treating. That's too many.
Yeah,
you know, that's a problem.
Yes.
That is a problem, okay?
Yeah.
And you cannot deny that things like this do happen. You just can't just erase it away. But you still have to be careful. DKB, no, Josh. Jet says, my point was simply mm-hmm. how powerful perception is. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? True. 901, before we leave today, got a few minutes before we leave. 901-213-6020 is the number to call. And if you want to comment on, somebody had made a comment on something earlier, and I meant to bring this out, John.
Okay.
Was that about the manager at the store we're talking about? It said hungry? No, that was the school manager.
Yeah.
The lady in there was talking about, these kids come home hungry. 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 Or is it hungry? I mean.
Well, hungry and hungry are two different.
I mean, come on.
But hungry is another level of hungry. That's like you.
No. Our kids are, they're not getting fed. They come home hungry. I mean, hungry. It should be hungry.
You never been hungry before?
Hungry. Hungry. I mean, you know, are y'all hungry? Are you which is it?
I almost feel like this is like autumn and fall conversation.
No. I'm not going to say that. But she was where's that thing you was at in the ghetto? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She was from the ghetto. I don't know if she said, well, I mean, you have people that are not in the ghetto that use the word hungry. Hungry. You know, people that say hungry, I bet they can cook some good mustard greens and collard greens and some cornbread, yes. Boy.
Pigfoot. Ham hocks.
Ham hocks, boy. I bet they can throw down. Y'all hungry? Boy, I bet they can cook some food, man. But when you see somebody saying, are you hungry yet? Yeah, you better not eat behind them. You might end up eating some of that food the maggots you found. Food all raw and everything, not cooked properly.
And not seasoned.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Yeah, but anyway, no, there are some people that can say hungry. And, you know, but.
Trying to survive.
Yeah. Yeah.
Trying to stay alive.
Yeah.
The ghetto.
Yeah. I'm hungry. Hungry.
Because.
Yeah. Just people are hungry. They get really hungry. Yeah. That's right. They ready to eat some greens and. Well, anyway.
There they go, piping them out. There's the crack again.
Boy. Anyway. Yeah, but anyway, hey. GKP says.
Go on, jump.
No, I too don't short. Want to jump.
Yes, you do. You smoke crack, don't you?
Yeah, he's, yeah. You know, I don't even know what crack is. I don't even know what is crack. I mean, is it a powdered substance or something like
that? You know,
washing powder or something, or is it really a rock or something you have to really crack?
See, that's the thing. Like, I heard that there's different types.
No.
Because I hear they talk about powder and they talk about crack. I don't know what the difference is, though, because I thought the powder was crack, and they said, no, that's powder.
Well, I mean, is it something like, is it like BC powder? BC powder.
That's what people always wonder.
You know what BC powder is. Don't come on here acting like you don't know what BC powder is. You know what that is. I mean, the same thing as BC powder, or is it more, is it like washing powder or something? I don't know.
Oh no, Jet says, hungry and crack just go together.
Oh, Lord.
Be hungry, crack, you know, crackheads, that's what they say.
He said, no, I be hungry.
Hungry, yeah.
Yeah, that's a big one there. Yeah. Hungry is too short, I think GKB was trying to say.
No, too short. Song.
Oh,
that's
together.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I don't know. But anyway.
He said, I'm jamming that one on Good Afternoon GKP today, Josh. Okay.
Yeah, I need to catch him, man, because I'd be missing GKP. And then I found out sometimes I just miss you. You just went off. And, man, I'd be mad, you know. But I need to.
He really does be upset when he misses him.
Yeah, I need to set an alarm, find out what time he coming on, set an alarm, you know, so I can you know, be advised. Okay, whatever you're doing, drop it. And, you know, it's GKP time.
GKP alert.
Yeah. Or I can turn it on where I'm at and keep moving on.
Yeah. Through the ghetto.
Through the ghetto. In the ghetto. You remember that song? That other song that we used to play?
In the ghetto.
In the ghetto. You know.
In the ghetto.
Yeah. It was something that said, in the ghetto. Or something. We used to play a long time ago. It wasn't a song we played. It was part of a clip. You know.
Oh, man. This must be a while ago.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's been a minute.
You know Elvis got a song in the ghetto? I didn't know.
Yeah, I knew Elvis. That's a song. In the ghetto. Yeah. It's been a long time since I...
Elvis lived in the ghetto.
He lived in Memphis.
Well, he lived in... I know that ain't the ghetto.
Yeah, well, that's Whitehaven.
Well.
You know, and some people used to say that was really white.
Back in the day?
Yeah. As the snow
flies. But this is totally different, yeah, didn't it?
Yeah.
On a cold and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in the ghetto.
What does he know about that?
Well, and his mama cried.
Then that reminds me of the ghetto.
Cause if there's one thing that she don't need, it's another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
Did he say hungry? Did he say hungry?
Let me go back.
There's one thing that she don't need, it's another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
Did he say hungry or hungry? I think he said hungry. Okay.
One more time.
Cause if there's one thing that she don't need, it's another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
I think it's kind of hungry.
I think he's kind of mixed on that.
Yeah, he's...
People, don't you understand?
Yeah, okay.
Child needs a helping hand.
All right.
He'll grow to be an angry young man someday.
Yeah, well. All right, Jet said, powdered... Then when you mix it and cook it? Wait a minute, Jet. Powdered. Then when you mix it and cook it?
Yeah.
I like cooking rice, ain't it? Or mashed potatoes or something? What is it? It turns into rock form. Okay. Are you saying in rock form, does it get hard?
Okay.
But the name comes from the sound it makes while cooking. Oh, okay. So it's making the sound crack, a cracking sound.
Okay. You know, because I know they be telling me they're cooking up crack, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, they got the pot and they're stirring. So I guess that's what that is. Okay.
Greg says, y'all be bumping too short. No, not really. Oh, yeah, GKB, he come up with the, I like this one, GKB, you got it. Santa Claus could go straight to the ghetto.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy, that's, you right on, I forgot about that one. Whoa, boy.
That show is, we played that too quite a bit.
Yeah, that's just what I heard. Okay, yeah. Okay.
That's what you heard. That's what you heard. Okay.
About the crack. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, that's all we got to go on.
Yeah.
We have to believe it. I'm just kidding.
Greg, look, you know, all the ingredients. But look, hold on. Let me see. Yeah, that's what I played. Greg must came in right after I played the ghetto from Too Short. Rick James got one called In the Ghetto.
Oh, really?
Jed is a fan of this Elvis song. And I've actually heard this before. It is a good song, really. I was laughing at it, but he's saying some real stuff on there.
Yeah.
Donny
Hathaway.
He's got a ghetto song as well.
My favorite of all. Really? All these people
got ghetto songs.
Oh, okay.
All right, Donny.
Maybe they all hungry.
Or they used to be. Now, what did Greg said, he went to Humes Junior High. So it's possible he lived in the hood, Elvis.
Oh.
I wouldn't be surprised. You know, Elvis got a little of that to him. You know what I mean? A little flavor, it seems like. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh. Is his best Mississippi accent.
In his best Mississippi accent.
Oh, yeah. in his best Mississippi accent. Okay. Too Short has a song, The Ghetto as well. Okay. Want to sing about the ghetto.
That's what I was saying. I just read about that because that was a song we just played. Was Too Short in the Ghetto.
Really?
Before the Elvis song.
Huh.
Okay.
I don't know nothing about Too Short.
But what I'm saying is either way, whether we know or not, that was the song that was played.
That was first. The song that was played by yeah. Too Short.
Yeah.
Too Short, okay. Is there a song that's called In the Ghetto by Too Tall?
Oh, see, there you go. Yeah. Inner City Blue. Yeah, okay. That's another song.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, a lot of ghetto songs.
Yeah, a lot of Inner City Blues, Jet said. Inner City Blues?
And that's, who was that by? I forget.
Humes, Jet said, Humes was white then. Jimmy Hart with the Humes as well.
Oh, okay.
Oh, really?
Old Jimmy Hart.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay.
Old classic Jimmy Hart back then.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, he's a character. Really. What is that?
Nah, I was just, that's... You don't hear it on here. I'm listening on my phone.
Oh, I heard something in the background there. Yeah. I didn't know what was going on there. I thought it was a disturbance. You know, Elvis lived down his mansion in Whitehaven. So now, from what I understand, y'all, before we leave the air today, from what I understand, I have been told that Whitehaven was mostly a white at one time.
Hence the name, right?
Yeah.
That's where the name came from, what I
that's
heard.
What I heard. Now, is it true? Is it true that Whitehaven was an all-white area and then blacks started moving in and they moved out? Is it true? You know, you hear people say something and, you know, just because the name white is there, they would say, okay, you know, that was once all white people there. So, I don't know.
Whitehaven, the haven for whites. And then White Station.
So, all white people lived there, too.
A station.
And they left there at one time. Okay, I don't know. I don't know. Is it really true that Whitehaven was an all white neighborhood at one time? You know, I don't know. But at any rate... Josh, I think that's going to do it for us today.
Yeah.
I don't see anybody leaving any message on that question that I asked. But at any rate, folks, hey, thanks for joining us today. Thanks for all your phone calls. Thanks for your messages. It's been a pleasure and a blessing to be on with you today. Hey, coming up at 2 o'clock this afternoon, Joshua ended all up with TalkBack Live Sports.
Yes, sir. Y'all
the Grizzlies, stay tuned. The Grizzlies, as expected, they did lose last night.
Yes. Yes, yes they did. But I'm going to tell you, there were some highlights from it. And just like I said, man, don't expect no bunch of wins from this Grizzlies team. No pressure. It's a young team. But there were some good things to take away from it, I think. So we'll talk about that. Plus, you
okay,
know,
how long do we put up with the Grizzlies? I mean, how long can we continue to go to the games and spend $110 for tickets and things like that and then $200 for tickets and then say, okay, we're just putting up with them? You can't keep putting up with people you pay that kind of money to go to a game.
Well, you got
to
know
these people need to come on and take care of business now. But I mean, they've been here long enough to, you know, talking about, well, we need to hang with them and hold on in there. You're spending $200
a
ticket.
This is a new team.
And, you know, I don't care if you're spending $5 a ticket.
This is a new team.
It doesn't matter.
These are young guys. Everybody's new. This is all the front office.
And you know what? And I think these Grizzlies, this Grizzly organization, I think they're just doing just enough to put a team in here so that well, just put any team in there,
yeah,
and we'll just keep rotating people in and out just so that those people be happy, and we'll just sucker their money out of them. All they want is a professional basketball team there. They don't care if it doesn't go all of it. The team doesn't win an NBA title or anything of that there or get to the playoff. They just want to have the name that, oh, Memphis has an NBA team and go to the game and spend all of that money, and they'll be satisfied. No.
But
people
look,
shouldn't be just settling for anything.
But let's remember, the Grizz had a streak of 7 straight years going to the playoffs.
That don't matter. What happened? Okay, they get knocked out the first round.
First or second.
Then
they had the 1 Western Conference Finals run.
Yeah, that was who, okay, and who? Hollins, and then they turned around and did what? Got rid of him.
You know,
okay, he took them too close to winning the whole thing. We don't want that in Memphis. Rid of Lionel Hollins. He took it too close. That's why they got rid of him. One of the reasons why they got rid of him.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think they don't mind winning championship.
The purpose,
but just maybe
the purpose
not
of the Memphis Grizzlies is not to win. They're just here to keep people satisfied so they have a basketball game to go to, and they can see the other teams come into town, like the Houston Rockets, the L.A. Lakers, and whoever else out there, you know, they can see those guys come to town and play every now and then. They'll be satisfied. Well, but, you know, I don't think the Grizzlies want a championship team. I don't.
I mean, that's your opinion, and I understand that thought, and we've talked about this for years, to be honest with you. I don't know, man. All I know is, to me, this year, don't expect nothing. Expect exciting play. Expect a young team that's going to fight and scratch and claw. But don't expect a bunch of wins this year. Okay. But I think time will grow.
Time will grow. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
They'll grow.
Okay. Good for us today as time grows. Hey, thanks for all your phone calls. Thanks for comments. And it's been a pleasure. We will see you next week on Talkback Live with Bob and Johnson. Good morning.
Yeah.
Have a wonderful weekend. If we need to cut in or bring a show on or
I'll be back later.
Some information, Johnson's back at 2 o'clock. But after that, then, you know, I may come in with some Bible teaching. You never know.
Yeah.
I've got some things I need to talk about. But other than that, if we find some news that are newsworthy or something, we may cut in and let you people in on what's going on around the metro area. Have a wonderful day, everyone.
Nachos cost $800. Well, in that case, they can get out of here. If that was true, they can get out of here.
If you're looking for some of the best old-fashioned burgers and steaks in town, Lotaburger is the place to go for all of your favorites. Lotaburger, 2260 South 3rd, Memphis, Tennessee, 901-946-2001. They're open Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6:45 p.m. And the items on their menu include single, double, triple burgers, Philly sandwiches, smoked sausage, beef hot dog, grilled cheese, tenders, fries, onion rings, and more. Call in orders must be done before 11 a.m. No calls accepted after 11 a.m. Drive-thru is available. Hungry for a burger? Lotta Burger. 2260 South 3rd, Memphis, Tennessee, 901-946-2001. Don't just settle for any burger. Get a Lotta Burger.
T-Graphic Printing, located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis. A complete print shop for all your printing needs. They do it all. Telecopy, resume, funeral program, rubber stamp, full color business cards, wedding and graduation invitations, and more. 30 plus years of quality work and service. They're open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Located at 890 East Range Road in Memphis, Tennessee, 901-345-9294. T-Graphic Printing.
Are you tired of going to the doctor with the same issue over and over again and never getting any relief? Are you tired of buying all types of vitamins and supplements, hoping but not knowing for sure that they will keep you healthy? Or are you getting enough of the right kind of nutrients that your specific body needs? If you answer yes to any of these questions, you need a nutritional blood analysis. With a nutritional blood analysis, we can take one drop of blood from a prick of your finger and analyze your body's nutritional needs, nutritional deficiencies, and nutritional imbalances. This analysis can provide an early warning of possible future health challenges, so you can make changes now to avoid a negative outcome. A nutritional blood analysis can be used to monitor a health challenge before and after adopting an approach to restore health and balance. It will also allow you the ability to determine the effectiveness of various approaches to restoring and balancing your health. So don't wait. Make your appointment. Stop guessing with your health. Know what works for sure. 901-602-7063.
CJU's Appliances, located at 3530 Jackson Avenue here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-487-7882. CJU's Appliances has the best prices in the town, sells and service heating and air, also the best appliances you'll find anywhere in the Mid-South. Refrigerators, microwave stoves, washers and dryers, deep freezers, dishwashers, whatever you need. And use appliances, and folks will tell you the best used appliances anywhere you find. That's CJU's Appliances, 3530 Jackson Avenue. All appliances come with warranty. You can call them at 901-487-7882. Again, 901-487-7882. CJU Appliances.
CNS Motors Auto Sales, located at 2508 Southern Avenue, here in Memphis, Tennessee. Call them at 901-323-8778. CNS Motors Auto Sales has been around since 1984. Go by and see Chris Day, some of the best pre-owned and used vehicles in the city. They have SUVs, minivans, cars, trucks, whatever you're looking for in pre-owned used vehicles. Hey, you can find it right there at CNS Motors Auto Sales. See Chris since 1984. They will treat you right. Call them at 901-323-8778. That's 901-323-8778. 2508 Summit Avenue, CNS Motors Auto Sales.
This is Sergeant Chris Richardson with the Tennessee Highway Patrol, here to explain the Tennessee Hands-Free Law, which is a new state law effective July 1st, 2019. In Public Chapter 412, it makes it illegal for a driver to hold a cell phone or a mobile device with any part of the body, to write, send, or read any text-based communication, to reach for a cell phone or a mobile device in a manner that requires the driver to no longer be in a seated driving position or properly restrained by a seatbelt, to watch a video or a movie on a cell phone or a mobile device, and to record or broadcast video on a cell phone or a mobile device. So, can I still talk to my cell phone while driving? Yes. A driver is permitted to use an earpiece, headphone device, or device worn on a wrist to conduct a voice-based communication. The driver may use one button on a cell phone or a mobile device to initiate or terminate voice communication, and voice-based communication may also be used to send a text message. Learn more at handsfreetn.com.